spacecraft test conductor for the lunar module reported that Eagle was go. The swing arm now coming back to its fully retracted position as our countdown continues. T-minus 4 minutes, 50 seconds and counting.
Will we meet in an hour of change and challenge? In a decade of hope and fear? In an age of both knowledge and ignorance? The greater our knowledge increases, the greater our ignorance unfolds. No man can fully grasp how far and how fast we have come. But condense, if you will, the 50,000 years of man's recorded history in a time span of but a half a century. We know very little about the first 40 years, except at the end of them, advanced man had learned to use the skins of animals. Then about 10 years ago, under this standard, man emerged from his caves. Only 5 years ago, man learned to write. Christianity began less than 2 years ago. The printing press came this year. And then less than 2 months ago, during this whole 50-year span of human history, the steam engine provided a new source of power. Newton explored the meaning of gravity. Last month, electric lights and telephones and automobiles and airplanes became available. Only last week did we develop penicillin and television and nuclear power. And now, if America's new spacecraft succeeds, we will have literally reached the stars before midnight tonight. But why, some say, the moon? Why choose this as our goal? And they may well ask, why climb the highest mountain? Why, 35 years ago, fly the Atlantic? Why does Rice play Texas? We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon. We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. If I would say, my fellow citizens, we shall send to the moon 240,000 miles away from the control station in Houston a giant rocket more than 300 feet tall, made of new metal alloys, some of which have not yet been invented, fitted together with a precision better than the finest watch, carrying all the equipment needed for propulsion, guidance, control, communication, on an untried mission to an unknown celestial body, and then return it safely to Earth, re-entering the atmosphere at speeds of over 25,000 miles per hour, causing heat about half that of the temperature of the sun, almost as hot as it is here today, and do all this, and do all this, and do it right, and do it first, before this big thing is out.
Seconds on the Apollo mission, the flight to land of the first men on the moon.
And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
T-minus 50, 55 seconds and counting. Neil Armstrong just reported back, it's been a real smooth countdown. We're on internal power with the launch vehicle at this time. Astronauts report it feels good. T-minus 25 seconds. 20 seconds and counting. T-minus 15 seconds. Guidance is internal. 12, 11, 10, 9. Ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4. file.
Oh, well, the Houston, you're good at 1 minute.
Downrange 1 mile, altitude 4 miles now. 8 miles downrange, 12 miles high. Velocity 4,000 feet per second. Downrange 35 miles, 30 miles high. Standing by for the upper engine cut down now.
Stand by for mode 1, Charlie. Mark, mode 1, Charlie.
Mark, Charlie.
You are go for staging. Houston, thrust is go. All engines, you're looking good.
Tower's
on. Roger, tower.
Houston, be advised, the visual is go today. Yeah, they finally gave me a window to look out.
Apollo 11, this is Houston. You are go for GLI, over.
Apollo 11, thank you. Altitude 177 nautical miles.
They confirm ignition, man. The thrust is go.
Climb velocity 35,570 feet per second.
Hey, Houston, Apollo 11 is gave us a bank deficit ride. All right, Roger, 11, we'll pass that on, and it certainly looks like you're well on your way now.
Houston, could you describe what you're looking at, over?
Roger, you're seeing Earth as we see it at our left-hand window, just a little more than a half Earth. We're looking at the eastern Pacific Ocean and the North America, Alaska, United States, Canada, Mexico and Central America. We can see the oceans with a definite blue cast, see white bands of major cloud formations across the Earth.
This is Apollo Control at 55 hours, 10 minutes. Our network controller has just advised that we are receiving live television. This extremely sharp, clear picture is coming to us from about 175,000 miles from Earth, presently about 48,000 miles from the Moon. It appears now that we have a view of Earth out the window.
11, Houston, if that's not the Earth, we're in trouble.
That's Big Mike Collins there.
Yeah, hello there, sports fans. You got a little bit of me, but Neil is the center couch, and Buzz is doing the camera work this time. We are very comfortable up here, though. We do have a happy home. There's plenty of room for the three of us, and I think we're all learning to find our favorite little corner to sit in. We've got coffee up here and various breakfast items. The food so far has been very good.
Yes, we stand back out to the distance at which we see the Earth. Apollo 11 signing off.
Roger, 11. Thank you very much. That was one of the greatest shows we've ever seen. We sure appreciate it, over.
This is Apollo Control at 75 hours, 26 minutes. Apollo 11 is 425 nautical miles from the Moon. We're 3 minutes away from loss of signal.
We'll see you on the other side, over.
Man, the Moon is there, boy.
Fantastic. Right back there behind us, it looks like a gigantic crater. Look at the mountains going around it. My gosh, they're monsters.
We're getting a beautiful picture in down here now, 11. We can see the horizon and the relative blackness of space.
And we're approaching the Terminator now. Contrast increase, and only the sunlit side of the bridges remain illuminated while the
dark sides and the shadow will become completely black.
I think you'll agree that some of these craters that you're seeing in the picture now are really accentuated by the lengthening of the shadows as we approach the Terminator.
There you have it, our first glimpse of the lunar surface during the Apollo 11 mission. This is Apollo Control, Houston. It is now July 20, the day scheduled for lunar landing.
Hello, Eagle, Houston, we're standing by, over.
Roger, Eagle, turn dark.
Roger, how does it look?
The Eagle has wings.
Okay, all flight controllers, go, no, go for power descent. Retro,
go.
Fido,
go.
Guide,
go.
Control,
go.
Telcom,
go.
GNC,
go.
Ecom,
go.
Surgeon,
go.
Capcom, we're go for power descent.
Eagle, Houston, and you ring, you're a go for power descent. Over.
Mission 10%. Altitude local high.
Houston, you're looking at our Delta H.
All right, good flight alarm.
Looks good.
Looking good to us, over.
Accepting its guidance.
1202.
Same,
1202. Right,
retro.
Go retro.
Throttle down. 6 plus 2
5. What is the reading on the 1202 flight alarm?
We have another 1202 alarm.
1202.
What's that?
It's executive overflow. If it does not occur again, we're fine.
We're going that flight.
We're going that alarm.
Set time, we're go flight.
Okay, we're go.
We're go. Train time, we're go.
Single alarm. Tell them to leave it alone and we'll monitor it, okay?
875 feet. Air's looking good. Down a half.
Roger. He's taking in the Delta H now.
Roger.
60 seconds.
2.5 now.
Ray shadow.
More forward.
More forward. Just into the right level.
Contact light.
Okay, engine stop.
Tranquility, we copy you on the ground. You got a bunch of guys about to turn blue. We're breathing again. Thanks a lot.
Okay, we're coming in for a minute.
Okay, keep the chatter down in this room.
Hatch reported coming open at 109 hours, 8 minutes, 5 seconds.
Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
I'm at the foot of the ladder. The lamp footbeds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches. And they'll step off the lamp now. That's one small step for man.
Thank you.
July 20th, 1969, humans walked on the moon for the first time. Hundreds of thousands of Americans worked together for this moment. Millions more were inspired by it. The United States is working to send humans back to the moon. The Artemis missions will carry the fire of Apollo under the same banner of freedom and peace. The spirit of Apollo is a world in which the sky is no longer the limit, and the moon is just the beginning.
We'd like to give a special thanks to all those Americans who built those spacecraft, who did the construction, design,